me atiendo. Second Corinthians, right after First Corinthians. Everybody got it?
Amen.
It says, the beginning with verse 7. It said, but we have this treasure in earthen vessels, that the excellency of the power may be of God and not of us.
Amen.
All right. We are troubled on every side, yet not distressed. We are perplexed, but not in despair. Persecuted, but not forsaken. Cast down, but not destroyed. Always bearing about in the body the dying of the Lord Jesus, that the life also of Jesus might be made manifest in our body. Look down with me at verse 17. For our light affliction, which is but for a moment, worketh for us a far more exceeding and eternal weight of glory. I want to talk about serving the Lord. Will pay off. Serving the Lord will pay off. I don't know about you, but if Paul, when he started this chapter, he said, therefore, seeing we have this ministry, as we have received mercy, we faint not. In other words, we don't give up. But when I look down here further, I see he lists several things that will make most folks give up. It will make most folks just turn around and say, forget this. That saying, I ain't into that. A lot of us, when we start out for God, we have had some mixed and messed up ideals about what serving God is all about. And a lot of us can't see God no further than our local church.
All right.
I want that one to sink in just a little bit. Some of us can't see God no further than our local assembly. But don't you know God is bigger than just little old Mount Zion?
Amen. All right.
He was God before Mount Zion got started.
Yes.
He uses Mount Zion that we might get a real glimpse of what ministry or what he is all about. It's the training station that we get a revelation of the power, the might, the omniscience of Almighty God. Now you can't get it if you don't come. You can't get it if you don't study. You can't get it if you don't pray for God to give it to you. A lot of us come to church all of our life and we still miss the message of this ministry. I wonder sometimes, is my desire to know God, is it something unique just because of my calling? But I think I was seeking God before I got called to preach. Y'all didn't catch that one. I mean, I had a sincere desire to know God before God ever called me. And matter of fact, the fact that I did desire to know him and got to know him helped reveal my calling to the ministry. It ain't like I was already preaching and I decided I'm going to study. No, no, no. I started studying before I got called to preach. In my mind, because God, the truth of the matter is God called me before while I was in my mother's womb, he knew me. He'd already called. But I didn't walk into the revelation until I got into his word. I got to know him for who he was. And you know, I'd have been happy just being a good member. I would. I just wanted to be saved. I did not want to die and lose my, and I realized that life had more to offer than what I would get. And the world wasn't going to give it to me, but when I started getting into the word, I found somebody that if you ain't got nothing, he can give you something. I found somebody in the word that even though the plight of my life looks so dim from the world perspective, but if I could hook up with him, he could beat all the odds. He could do something with me that nobody else would even try or want to do. So I decided to hook up with Jesus. And thank God I did. Thank God I did. Rather, thank God he revealed his hookup in me. And when I submitted my will, now watch this. This is where a lot of folk don't get him, because you won't submit your will. See, we some will, big-headed, hard-headed folk. And we got a big mind of our own and we think we know what's what, and we know nothing. When I submitted my will to his will, that's when things started turning around. That's when I shown up, had a new walk and a new talk and a new ambition, a new desire, a new purpose in life. When I submitted my will to his will. That's easier said than done. Submit my, give up my idea, give up my mindset to do it God's way. And then when I do it God's way, I start reading about the results of what was going on. Anybody say, man, you must be crazy. When I look at Paul talking about this ministry in the 4th chapter of 2 Corinthians, he don't really paint a real pretty picture unless you look deep into what he says. He don't paint a good picture. As a matter of fact, he down here where I take, he acknowledges that the word of God is precious. And he acknowledged that we are really unable to carry out on our own. Amen. He realized that we need the presence, the power of God in our life in order to function in ministry. And he says, we have this ministry, seeing that we got this ministry. And I want you to see it, because this is a ministry that may not make no real sense to most folk, because listen, look, it's totally in opposition with world thought, with the ways and the thinking of the world. No wonder the Bible said, my ways are not your ways. My thoughts are not your thoughts. My thoughts and ways is as high above yours as heaven is earth. And in order to get on that plane, you've got to come down and submit your will to the will of God. And you'll start seeing things in a new light. He says, what God has done, that his word is precious. The same word that heaven and earth may pass away, but my word shall live forever. He said God has packaged that word and put it in earthen vessels. Yeah, he put it in me. Amen. Yeah, but he ain't no good. He still put it in me. I remember him when he was thus and thus, but God still have packaged his word and wrapped it up in earthen vessels. See, his word is so powerful that if he can put it in an earthen vessel, and really he put it in an earthen vessel because it really demonstrates the power of his word. If he can put it up in a messed up earthen vessel like you and me and produce wholesome fruit and produce power from on high, God is real if nothing else is real. He said we have, and Paul said this word of God is a treasure. We have this treasure in earthen vessels. And Paul tell why God put it there. He said that the excellency of the power may be of God and not of us. Yeah, I like that. Because you see, I realize there's no way I can accomplish what God accomplished through me and in me of my own. I realize there has to be a power. There has to be some kind of treasure weak way down in me somewhere that I can't even explain. Got to be. It can't be me. I don't know about y'all, but I know who me was. So it can't be me. But Paul said, we have this treasure in earthen that God put his word. You know, it amazes me. And what I like about God, the very folk that folk point their finger at and cast down, that's who God will deposit his word in. And when he make a deposit, that's why he told Timothy, God that deposit, God that word that is in you. Don't let nothing snatch it away from him. It's your power. The word of God is the only power I have. In earthen vessels. He said, but because God has packaged it, wrapped it up, in folk like you and me. He said, don't you think the devil is happy about that? He said, because it's there, and because God has done it so, we are troubled on every side. Wait a minute. What about just one side, Lord? No, every side. You mean when I try to go forward, I got to meet trouble? Okay. Yeah. When I try to turn around and want to run, go backwards? Yeah. Go to the right or go to the left? Yeah, it's there. We are troubled on every side. But now, don't you worry, because that's a treasure that's in you that ain't, don't worry about trouble. that treasure that God has put in us ain't worried about trouble. Because look, the devil's always trying to block us, trying to surround us, trying to box us in on every side. But watch what God did. What didn't y'all see the devil? Didn't y'all see the devil sin in the world, box Jesus in on the cross? They hung him on the cross. Couldn't go by the cross. Nailed to the cross. Folk in front of him, mocking him, making fun of him. Put a thief on one side, another thief on the other side. Boxed him in on every side. What I love about Jesus, though, when you got this treasure, Jesus was the treasure. All right. The treasure took one of the sides and saved it. The thief said, hey, Lord, when you get where you're going, remember me. Jesus said, today, you're going to be with me in paradise. In other words, I right now, in your dying moment, I'm going to allow you to change teams. Praise God. You've been on the other side, but right now, I'm going to put you on my team, and because you're on my team today, you're going to be with me. So don't worry about being troubled on every side. He said, even though we're troubled on every side, we are not distressed. The reason we're not distressed is because we got somebody that's in us.
All right.
And he, greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. We have this treasure in earthen vessels. God put a treasure in us that will sustain us through all odds, all difficulty, all trouble. We're troubled on every side, yet not distressed. We are perplexed, but not in despair. Listen, I know what you're talking about, because some of y'all can perplex me. But I'm not in despair. You know why? Because my eyes is on something higher. My eyes is on a larger goal. I can look beyond what you distress me with and see a brighter day ahead. He said, we are perplexed, but not in despair. That's when you got this treasure in you. Now, some folk can't see that, because maybe if you can't see it, maybe you don't have the treasure in you. You got to have it in you. And the only one that can put it in you is God. I don't care how much school you go to. I don't care how much. Listen, there's something about when God can lay his hands on you. It's, you ain't the only one to know it. Somebody else see it. They might not want to acknowledge, but they see it. They know he there. What you said? What you trying to do? When God can put something in you, somebody gonna see it.
Amen.
Somebody gonna know it. Because God is just too great and too good to go unrecognized. We're troubled on every side, yet not distressed. We are perplexed, but not in despair. Persecuted, but not forsaken. Listen, y'all, he promised never to leave me alone. Yes, I've been persecuted. That's when folk go out of their way to try to pull you down. but he, now listen, let me tell y'all something. Just because you get on God's side, a lot of folk go around, he'll keep you from all hurt, harm, and danger. No, he never said he would keep you from all hurt, harm, and danger. But he did promise, lo, I'll be with you. Y'all ain't hear me this morning. So if you got the idea the devil told you that lie, that you were going to be kept from all hurt, harm, who do you think you are? You're going to have trouble just like everybody else. You're going to be ditched and talked about like everybody else. But when you got that treasure in you, you got a promise that, Lord, I will be with you always. Persecuted, but not forsaken. Then he said, we are cast down. Y'all know, but not destroyed. It's a pity. It hurts my heart sometimes to see how folk talk about preachers. Y'all laugh, and it ain't funny. Because regardless of what you think about them, God's still going to put this treasure in them. And the treasure he put in his preacher, you need it. Y'all ain't
preaching.
He said, we're cast down. You don't believe preacher cast down? Go by the beauty shop. Go by the barber shop. Sometimes you ain't got to go there for, sometimes just wait there after church and go out of the parking lot and tip up on a conversation. But in all of y'all's casting down, God said he won't let it destroy us. Y'all ain't hearing me. We're cast down, but not destroyed. He said we're always bearing about in the body the dying of the Lord Jesus, that the life also of Jesus may be made manifest in our body. Y'all ain't caught that. I know y'all a little slow on me this morning. He said we always, in other words, when he put that treasure in, Satan attacks us just like he attacked Jesus. He tried to pull us down just like he tried to pull down Jesus. But in every situation, how many know he thought he had him on Friday? But Sunday morning. Yeah. He says, for the which cause we live, we always delivered unto death for Jesus' sake, that the life of Jesus might be made manifest in our mortal flesh. So then death worketh in us, but life in you. You know, the more y'all kill us, the more life we try to give you. Y'all ain't hearing me. Yeah, we having the same spirit of faith. According as it is written, I believed, therefore have I spoken. Paul said, we also believe, and therefore speak. In other words, I'm going to keep on preaching because I believe. I believe in the gospel of Jesus Christ. I believe in the power of Jesus. Yeah, Paul, what it goes on to say, yeah. He said, because we got Jesus, y'all. Because we got this earthly treasure. Because Satan is always trying to pull us down. He said, I want you to know that ain't nothing but a little light affliction. Yeah, which is but for a moment. I'm at verse 17 in case you're wondering. He said, working for us a more exceeding and eternal weight and glory. Oh, Paul, thank you, because even though I understand that we got to suffer some things in life, I understand we're going to be troubled on every side. I understand we're going to be cast down. Folk going to scandalize our name. They're going to call our good works evil. Paul said, but that's just a light affliction. He said, but it's working, and it's just for right now. It's working, you are more eternal weight in glory. Oh, ain't that good news? Paul said, Leon, don't worry about being troubled. Don't worry about trials and tribulation. Just keep on talking. Because after a while, serving the Lord is going to pay off. What you're going through right now ain't going to even compare to what God got waiting on. No wonder the Bible says, I have not seen, ear have not heard, either have it entered into the heart of man what God got prepared for them that love him. And I don't know about y'all today, but yes, I'm troubled. Yes, I've been persecuted. Yes, I've been cast down. But praise God today, I found out that serving my God, it's going to pay off after a while. Oh, after a while, I'm going to get paid for working. I'm going to get paid for crying in the midnight hour. Ain't he all right? Hey, 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 yes! Serve the Lord. What you saying, preach, I'm saying, keep on doing for God, no matter what
storm may rise, but keep on tolling. Wind may blow, but keep on tolling. Storm, lightning may flash, thunder may roar. I found out he promised me never to leave me alone. No, no, never alone. That's why he always come out a winner at the finishing line. Yeah, yeah. Don't look at my condition right now, but wait, after a while, I said after a while, God gonna wipe tears from my eyes. God gonna take God Almighty. I'm gonna get a starry crown. Yeah. Serving the Lord will pay off, y'all. Ain't he good? Not just sometimes, but ain't he good all the time? God bless you if the door is open.
Hey!
Savior's face I shall see, serving Lord, it's gonna pay off.